right, I need to simmer down and stop myself right there before the copyright police come and get me. But I just can't resist on this guitar. Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is obviously a Kramer Jersey Star. Made famous by Sister Rosetta Tharpe, the Jersey Star. Now, it's obviously Richie Sambora from Bon Jovi. This was his signature guitar back in the 80s. He moved on and got different guitars. Kramer went away in the 80s, but now they're back with a vengeance under Gibson's umbrella. And it's the best thing to happen to the guitar world since sliced bread. I don't know. Anyways, but this guitar became an entity in itself away from Sambora. This three pickup Kramer, the stars on the neck, the white and gold is just iconic, either with Sambora or just Kramer as a whole. If you can't tell, I'm extremely giddy about this guitar. I'm so pleased it's back. It's absolutely fantastic and obviously available at PMT, so your fair hands can give it a bash. Kramer itself is one of my favorite, well, probably my favorite guitar brand because it encapsulates everything I love about these daft things that we call guitars. And the point is to have fun with it and evidently be a bit obnoxious, which I absolutely love. And there's nothing quite as obnoxious as a Jersey Star. But luckily, because like it's got all the feel to back it up. It plays amazing, it sounds amazing, it's versatile. Besides the fact it catches your eye with the way it looks, as soon as you play one, you realize there's so much under the hood of this guitar. It's awesome. And firstly, in this video, I'll be talking you through the specs of the Jersey Star and then showing you what it sounds like. I'm using two Atec cables into a Daddario chromatic pedal tuner, into a PV6505 mini head, very fitting, I thought, for this guitar. Blackstar cab mic'd up with a Lewitt MTP440 microphone. It just does everything, it's so cool. I'm well aware that this guitar isn't for everyone, so if you've made it this far into the video, awesome, let's talk about some specs. So it's not too dissimilar to the original Sambora models from back in the 80s. Alder body, and it's the Jersey Star shape, so it's a slightly more contoured, slightly smaller Stratocaster shape. It's got a bolt-on maple neck with an elliptical C profile, which is unique to the Jersey Star, but it is quintessentially Kramer. It's if you've played old Kramers or even new Kramers, it's just that kind of vibe where you know it's vintage, but it's not too thin. It's not like an Ibanez shreddy neck. It's like got a bit of girth to it. It's lovely. Maple board as well, a 16-inch radius, so it's lovely and flat with those stars. 22 frets, and there's stars from the first to the 21st fret. Mother of pearl with a black outline, and you can see one right here on the body, and up at the top of the headstock. Speaking of the headstock, there's lots of bling up here. There's a mother of pearl truss rod cover with JS on for Jersey Star, and the gold tuning peg, all the hardware's gold if you hadn't noticed already. The gold tuning pegs have mother of pearl buttons, which is awesome. It's even got a little gold toolkit on the back for the Floyd Rose. R2 Floyd Rose locking nut, and a Floyd Rose 1000 trem, which is just awesome. It's kind of half floating, so you can pull back a little bit, but you can slam it down if you don't want it floating. Now for the pickups and the amazing electronics on the Jersey Star. Three humbuckers, three proper Seymour Duncan humbuckers, two JBs in the bridge in the middle, and a jazz in the neck. The JB and the jazz is the ultimate Seymour Duncan combo, in my humble opinion, for this kind of music. But you've just got an extra middle humbucker, the JB, just because why not? Just because Sambora could back in the day and Kramer still can now. One volume control, no tone control, and a five-way switch, but it's angled slightly differently. That's the way he liked it back then. And it's quite interesting. Normally in positions 2 and 4, you can get some cool single coil tones out with three humbucker guitars or HSH guitars, but literally the middle humbucker is engaged the entire time. So there's either bridge, position 2 is both these pickups, and the middle is just the middle pickup. Then the same for position 4, the neck in the middle, and finally the neck pickup at the top. The two little switches down here are coil taps for the bridge pickup and the middle pickup. The neck is just the humbucker regardless. I think that's all the specs. Let's hear it some more. This is just some more bridge pickup because it sounds kick-ass. You can't just not shred on it. It's great for chord work. It's great for rhythm stuff. Now, you will hear some clean stuff at the end, but let's go through the dirt. So this is a single coil of that bridge humbucker. Cool set. I mean, there's a lot of gain there, so hopefully you can hear it. If you do want to, one, play some more Bon Jovi songs so I don't get dumped by copyright, and two, hear this thing in person, you've got to rock up to your local PMT store and try one out because it's awesome. So, that single coil again. Let's go to the next pickup now. For the creaminess. Copyright, sorry. Middle humbucker now. So you get a totally different tonal characteristic. It's something you're probably not familiar with because guitarists rarely hear humbuckers in the middle position. And even though it's the same as the bridge, it does sound very different because it's picking up the strings from a different part of the neck, of the length of the strings. More obvious, so that's a single coil in the middle pickup. The creaminess is replaced with a bit of mid-focused honk. But let's clean it up now. A bit. I don't know if I go too clean. This is the full bridge humbucker. That single coil really shines through. So this is a really cool setting I found. This is the bridge pickup single coil with the middle pickup humbucker. Single coil them both if you like. The neck humbucker now. Thank you. And I think, ladies and gents, that's all the sight, specs and sounds I can get out of the unbelievable Kramer Jersey Star. Just one hell of a guitar and way more versatile than what you think. You have to play one to believe one, the neck's lovely, the fingerboard edges are lovely, and the tones you can get out of it will tick every box that your heart desires. It's absolutely awesome. Please comment down below what you think of the Jersey Star. Do you own one? Have you played one from back in the day? Did you play one of the crazy music yo ones from the 2000s? Because now Gibson have ownership of Kramer, and they're doing so well to make them just more awesome than they've ever been, in my humble opinion, and that's a bold statement. Try one of the new ones because they're absolutely fantastic. Let me know down below what you think about it. And if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Kramer Jersey Star, or any Kramer for that matter, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.